I've been watching you from a distance as I turn out all the lights. All I want from you is to listen and remember the good times. If you think of all that we leave out, is that weird you're feeling good? I know nothing ever turned out as you wanted to. My name is Susan Smith, and I'm a teacher at Parks Junior. Teaching has been everything for me. My friend said, we're going to go to Disneyland and apply for a job. And they all said, yeah, we're going to all apply. Again, nothing I ever did was well planned. I just felt like the universe just dragged me along into these amazing opportunities. I almost didn't even leave Disneyland, but after a while, things happened. So again, this is where I got pulled in by friends. I had some friends who were building a boat in their backyard, and they asked me if I wanted to go with them, if I wanted to help them build the boat and take off. And since school was sort of a wash for me, and the idea of traveling around the world in a boat sounded pretty good, I did that. And I did this, I took two trips. We traveled to Hawaii a couple times. I lived on the boat for a few years. But because I had to quit Disneyland to do that, it kind of left me hanging. So I just did job after job. Some were fun, some I hated. But eventually we settled down, and it was like I was in my late 20s, and actually I think I was in my early 30s, and it was like, I better get a real job. And again, here's the luck. I'm telling you, as I tell this story, I just kind of look at myself and think how lucky I am. You know, I always thought motion pictures would be great. Don't we all think that? I didn't want to be an actress, but I always thought the motion picture business was exciting. There was one show that was prepping in pre-production, and it was Star Trek IV, and it was the only one there. Somebody pointed us in the direction of the producer. They only give the job to somebody they know. Well, it turns out I kept going there so often, they knew me. So I became the person that they knew. That's how I got my first job on Star Trek. Because I thought I could, I got it. Because Star Trek was such a well-known show, I had no problems getting other jobs. It's a tough field, because when you're working on one show, you're always looking for the next one, because it's not like working at the school district where you always know where you're gonna be working the next time. When you're working on one show, you know it's going to end. And everybody's going to have a wrap, and they'll have a party if you're lucky, and then they're going to say goodbye, you'll never see them again, or maybe if you're lucky, you'll see them on another shoot. But then you've got to find another job. Jumped around doing, sometimes I get on shows and they would, almost always I was considered a production assistant, but almost on all of the shows I got to do more. So, but I never made it above that. And what happened, I might as well tell you this. After I did that for a few years, I got tired. I really don't like motion pictures. I mean, I'm so blessed that I actually got to do the dream jobs. I got to do what I thought was exciting, but I didn't have the training. Motion pictures, what it did for me, it gave me huge amounts of confidence, because I wound up doing things I had never thought I could do before. This is one of the things I learned over the years, is that you don't always know what you're going to like in your job, but you learn very quickly what you hate. But here's the number one thing that it gave me. I don't have any regrets. That's huge. But the only reason I became a teacher was because at my age, I was running out of options. At 45, it's hard to get entry-level positions anymore. And since I didn't want to go in the fields that I was in before, when my friend suggested teaching, I thought, okay, this is it. I'm going back to school, I'll become a teacher, and I can do it. And it's the best job I've ever had. I've never had a job that even comes close to satisfying me the way teaching has. So again, I've been so lucky in all the things that have happened to me, but it's almost like somebody keeps opening doors for me, and I just keep going through them.